Hey everyone, Johnny B here with Devslopes.com, and I am super excited to teach you all about Mapbox. Mapbox is an incredible framework that allows you to build experiences for exploring the world. As a developer, working with user location can be difficult, but with Mapbox, it is a lot easier to add location services into any application with their mapping, navigation, and location search SDKs. There is so much that Mapbox can do for you. It supports iOS, Android, Web, Unity, and Qt out of the box. So let's take a look at the app that we are going to build in this series. I got it open right here, and it shows our location, which I have set to San Francisco. And when I tap anywhere on the map, it goes ahead and drops a marker and overlays the best route to that location. And then when you're ready to get going, all you gotta do is click on Start Navigation, and we will begin turn by turn directions. And you can choose to have those turn by turn directions muted or not. You can also click here to report any issues, such as road closures or bad routes. And this information goes straight to Mapbox to improve their maps over time. All right, so this is, you know, pretty snazzy. And you may be thinking, wow, this looks like a lot of work. But it's really not using Mapbox, all right? So let's get started and hope you guys are excited because this is gonna be a lot of fun. All right, so I got here a pretty much brand new, fresh, empty Android Studio project. I have added a few things that we are going to go over though. And in this video series, we are going to be using Android Studio version 3.1.2 and Kotlin as our programming language. We do have a Java series as well, so if that's what you want to use, go and check that one out. All right, so to use the Mapbox SDK, we first need to add them as a dependency. So come over to your build.gradle module app, and down here at the bottom, this is where we have our Mapbox dependencies. We're gonna start out with these two, the Android SDK, and the current version is 6.0.1. And then we are also going to be using the plugin location layer, which is currently 0.5.0. Now, if these are updated by the time that you are watching these, then Android Studio will probably prompt you, or you can check out the Mapbox documentation. If you get this crash, you are also going to need this little bit of code here, the compile options. And this is just setting the source and target compatibility. Also in your project build.gradle file, under the repositories, make sure you have added Maven Central. Next up, to use Mapbox, we are going to need an API key, okay? So if you haven't already signed up, go to mapbox.com and create your free account, and your API key will be right there when you log in. Go ahead and copy that, and then we're going to open up our values folder here in under the resources folder, go to strings.xml, and create a new string resource named access token, and then just go ahead and paste your API key that you get from your Mapbox account. The next change is optional. I went ahead and just added some color resources. I changed all of the default primary and accent colors to the Mapbox blue, which is hex 426 4FB. And then we also have three more colors here, Mapbox white, Mapbox blue, and Mapbox gray light, just to kind of make our app have the same theme as the Mapbox colors. Lastly, we are going to need to add some permissions to our Android manifest.xml file. So I'm going to open that up. And right here, we are going to say uses permission. And the one that we want is access fine location. Okay. Now you can use either fine or coarse location here, but it is recommended to use the fine location to get the best accuracy. And with that little bit of setup, we are now ready to add our first map. Okay. So we are going to add it into our layout file here under activity main.xml. And we're going to be here in the text view. And we're just going to get rid of this text view here. And we are going to add in our map view. Okay, so go ahead and do open angle bracket. I'm going to say com.mapbox. And this is the one that we want right here. So that's nice. And we're going to say match parent. And let me close this. And match parent. And I'm going to go ahead and remove this close tag here and put it right there. And then right here with our res auto here, instead of app, make that say Mapbox. So now we have added our map view widget. Let's go ahead and add some properties, okay? So if you think about what you need in a map, you usually need to know where to look. So let's go ahead and set some camera target latitude and longitude, okay? So I'm gonna say Mapbox colon map box underscore camera target lat. Okay, so this is where we want the map view to initialize to. So I'm going to say 37.7749. And then we got to give it a longitude as well. So I'm going to say Mapbox colon Mapbox underscore camera target LNG for longitude. And that is going to be -122.4194. Okay, so this is going to be right on San Francisco. And then what we want to do is provide a style for our map. And Mapbox supplies several styles that we can use, such as Mapbox streets, outdoors, light theme, a dark theme if it's night, satellite, even has traffic, okay? So I'm gonna show you the first one we're gonna do is just the default Mapbox streets. So to do that, we say Mapbox colon Mapbox underscore style URL, and we're gonna say equal, and that is located at Mapbox colon slash slash styles slash Mapbox slash streets dash V10. Okay, so this is one of these styles, streets dash V10. And then the last thing that we're gonna do is give it a zoom level. Okay, so I'm gonna say Mapbox underscore camera zoom. It's equal to 12. Okay, and you can play with this zoom level and find one that looks good for you. All right, so we're finished up here in the XML for now. Now let's go ahead and open up our Java folder and come down to our main activity. And we are going to need to create ourselves a variable here for our map view. Okay, so I'm gonna say private latinit var, and we're gonna call it map view, and it is of type map view. And then here in our on create, what we're going to do is we are going to get Mapbox the information that it needs. It needs the context and our access token. So I'm going to say Mapbox dot get instance, and we're going to pass in the application context. So I'm going to say application context, and then we need to give it the access token. So I'm going to say get string. And the string that we want to give it is r.string.accessToken. There we go. So now Mapbox has the API key and the context so it can do what it needs to do. Now let's go ahead and find that map view. So I'm gonna say map view is equal to find view by ID, and the ID that we gave it is map view. Actually, I think we forgot to give it an ID. So let's jump back into activity main.xml and let's go ahead and say Android ID and give it an ID of map view. There we go. Now when we're back here, that should be good. Yep, there we go. And to initialize our map view, all we gotta do is say map view dot on create and pass in the saved instance state. And that should be all we need to do to be able to see our map. So I'm gonna go ahead and run this. All right, and here we are. We have ourselves a map of San Francisco, and you can pan around, you can rotate, you can tilt it, you can do a lot of stuff right out of the box. So that is pretty cool. And just to recap, all we had to do was add our dependencies, add our API key, and add the map to our XML, and then initialize it here in code. Now, the map view contains its own lifecycle methods for managing Android's OpenGL lifecycle, which must be called directly from the containing activity. So in order for our app to correctly call the map view's lifecycle methods, we're gonna have to override the activity lifecycle methods. Okay, so let's go ahead and do that real quick. So we got on start, and then what we need to do is just call the map view's corresponding lifecycle methods. So on start, map view on start. Then we have on resume, map view dot on resume. Then we have on pause and map view dot on pause. Then let me scroll down here, get this centered. Then we have on stop. I'm gonna say map view dot on stop. There we go. On destroy and map view dot on destroy. On save instance state. And we're gonna say here, if the out state does not equal null, then we will say map view dot on saved instance state and pass in the out state. And lastly, we have on low memory. Okay, so we're gonna say map view dot on low memory. All right, so now we have our lifecycle methods in. And before we finish up this video, I just want to show you a couple of those other styles that I was talking about. So here we have streets-v10. Some of the other ones are dark-v9. So let's go ahead and see what that looks like. Ooh, very nice. Another one that they have is traffic-day-v2, and they also have traffic-night-v2. So let's go ahead and see what that looks like. All right, and you can see here, wow, look at all that red traffic in San Francisco. All right, so there's your traffic. All right, so that's just a couple of examples of the different styles that you have available to you. If you want to check out the rest, you can go check out the documentation. And that's where we're going to go ahead and finish up this video. In the next lesson, we're going to do some more exciting stuff and bring in the user's location. All right, so hope you're excited for that, and I will see you in the next one.